Hallelujah. Moving in power. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, come on, Angie. You want to pray down there?
I could just feel the weight of the Father's heart for his children and his love for him, especially the ones who have been going through. It has been hard for them to press through and still give him the glory he deserves because they were focused on the circumstances. But the Lord is with you and he deserves glory for it all. So, Father, I just thank you for your children. I just thank you, Lord, for the victory over the things that we face in our lives, God. No matter what the circumstances is, you deserve the glory in it all, God. There is nothing that deserves glory more than you. And I pray that you will fix our eyes on you, to turn our hearts back to you and fix our eyes on you, God, in the midst of those situations, Father God. I just thank you right now, Lord, that every weight and every burden that each and every one of your children is carrying, God, those that are bold enough to say it and those who feel like aren't strong enough to talk about it, I just thank you right now for lifting every burden from every heart in this place, Lord. And I stand as an intercessor for the ones who aren't even able to pray, God. And I lift them up before your throne of grace, God. And I just thank you, Lord, for lifting the weight and the burdens. For your burden is easy and your yoke is light. And I thank you for the families in this house, Father God. I thank you for each and every family, Lord. And I just feel like there were different families in this building who households have been attacked and they felt the weight of that, Lord. But I just thank you for the victory. I plead the blood of Jesus over every family in this household, God. And I just thank you for the salvations of the household from the confessions of their faith, Lord Jesus. And I just thank you that they would not fear, Lord, but they would equip themselves with your full armor, that they would press in even deeper, God, to give you glory, to give you praise, Lord Jesus. And even if they don't know how to pray, I thank you that the Holy Spirit will make intercession for them, God. And even as they open their mouths, the words will come. For we have victory over the enemy. He does not have victory over us. We have dominion over him. He does not have dominion over us. From the power of your Son, God, each and every one of us have the power of the Holy Spirit living inside of us, and we are not going to succumb to the plans of the enemy or its tactics or its ways. And I just rebuke the enemy right now in the name of Jesus over every family in this household. You have no place, and I serve you notice right now, Satan, that you are cast out in the name of Jesus. You have no place. We have victory over you by the blood of Christ, and by his stripes the family that are sick are healed in the name of Jesus. By his stripes the broken hearts are healed. By his stripes, by the wounds that he has taken in our place, we don't have to carry it. And Father God, I thank you for the victory. We are victorious. We're not going to stand down. We're going to stand up by the mighty power of God that works within us, and we are going to hold on to that power, and we are going to trust in God in the midst of the circumstances. Lord, we trust you. We're going to worship you harder in the midst of what we see, because Lord, we trust you. And we thank you right now, Father God, for the victory over every circumstances, for the victory, God, because we are victorious in you. We are victorious in you. And God says, do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for he will help you with his righteous right hand. He is right there with you and with his righteous right hand. And I thank you for your love, God. I thank you for your love, for it covers over a multitude of sins. And that is nothing, God. That is nothing that will separate us from your love. Not angels, nor demons, not life, nor death, not the present or the past or what's to come. Nothing can separate us from your love. And I thank you, God, for your love. I thank you, Lord, for your love that covers all. To every family that's going through, I stand in agreement right now in the name of Jesus with every prayer and petition that you have sent to heaven. And God, I pray that your ears would be attentive to our prayers. But we have humbled ourselves before you. We have called on your name. We have sought your face, God. So let your plans come, God, for our lives, God. Answer the prayers of your people, for you care for us. You said exodus shall be given, God, and I ask. And I thank you, Lord, that it will be given in the name of Jesus. To every person that's been petitioned in heaven, I just feel the Holy Spirit saying, over the course of this next week, you watch and see the answers for your prayers. You watch, for the answers are on the way. And I see angels being released from heaven to answer your prayers. Warrior answers, angels who are fighting in the spirit realm for you on behalf of your prayers. And the answers will come. The answers will come. The answers will come.
Oh, turn the keyboard on, please. Yeah. Right now, Lord, we ask for deliverance where every area needs to be delivered and set free, Father God. I speak it over each one of us, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Come forth, Holy Spirit. Come forth and fill the areas. Fill us, Father God. Fill us again, Father God. Let yourself be filled, says the Lord. Release the idols. Release the opinions. Release the things that God is saying no more. Release them and let him fill. Let him fill. Let him fill. Turn the microphone on, please. Let him fill what needs to be filled.
And right now we command every mental illness to go in the name of Jesus. And we declare complete mental clarity, a sound mind. For God has not given you a spirit of fear and timidity, but of power, love, and a sound mind. And we declare over everyone, depression, your days are over. Bipolar, your days are over. Paranoia, schizophrenia, all of the mental illness is named. You are named under the name of Jesus. And we lift up the name of Jesus. And we declare our children and our children's children will be free from all mental illness in Jesus' name. And we declare, Father, just transformation, God, over every mind right now in Jesus' name. Right now. Ho! Freedom right now. Freedom right now. Jesus. I want somebody to run up here and pray for healings right now. Right now, come on, Spirit of the Lord is moving and healing.
There's fire coming down. There's fire coming down in your back. In your back. There's fire coming down in your back. Somebody's tooth. Somebody's tooth, I can feel healing in the nerves of your tooth, the front tooth. Thank you, Father God. Also in the heel. In the heel, in the calf, in the shin. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God, for healing. He died for your sins. He died for your iniquities. He died for your transgressions. He died for your chastisement. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for releasing healing. Thank you for your anointing for healing, Father God, in the chest, in the chest, in the lungs, in the lungs, in the lungs, in the lungs. Be gone in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. Thank you for your fire, fresh fire, Father, in the name of Jesus. In your throat, everything. Sinuses, everything. Everything, everything. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father Yahweh.
We thank you, Lord. By your stripes we are healed. We thank you, Lord, that healing is the children's bread. Also, deliverance is the children's bread. We just release deliverance right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, we don't have to be bound anymore. We don't have to be bound when the Spirit of the Lord's moving like this. I see you guys come forward. Right now, I feel like the Lord's just taking these two. They're like, they've been pillars, but they've been pillars in private. And the Lord's going to give, open the eyes of their heart, God, because there's going to be such a clarity. And he's going to take your prophetic gift out of obscurity into definition. And there's going to be like HD. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, we declare, Lord, that there will be clarity like they've never seen before. It will be details that will guide the realms of the Spirit, Lord. It will allow us, Lord, to I believe this is for other prophetic voices, but the Lord is stirring up the prophetic voice in you two to see so clear that you'll be able to give guidance into people's lives, and there's going to be just an awareness to pray into those things and transform. Even the plans of the enemy are going to come to naught because of the prayers of the righteous avail much. And we just declare, Lord, right now, for that level of clarity to come upon them. And we thank you, Lord, for just a new level right now. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, for all the attacks, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that we were able to be acquainted with your sorrows, but now we say, Lord, let us reign with you. Let them reign with you. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art! How great thou art! Kala lalene neishti kala mene.
Hallelujah. Pastor Jeff, just come up here. We're just going to have you just pray right now. Thank you for all that you're doing. I just want you to pray a prayer covering over everything that God's doing, over the hearts, the minds. Rosha Yabati.
Roko Sandaradeti. Padaramande Sitaradadosata. Oh, Lord, we just thank you, O God, for how you're entering, O God, at this house on this afternoon, O God. How you moved, O God, through the worship time, O God, and how you touched each person, O God, on this afternoon, O God. We ask, O God, that you would just continue, O God, to work in each person, O God, throughout this week, O God, and that every prayer, O God, that's been prayed up to this point, during this service of God. We will begin to see the testimonies and miracles of God and the manifestation of your power throughout this week, oh God. We just thank you, oh God, for every man, every woman, every child, oh God, that's here, oh God. Those that are receiving the deliverance at this altar, oh God, that they would maintain the deliverance, oh God, and that you will allow them to walk into new favor, new victory, oh God, new territories, oh God. We just thank and we bless you, Father. We thank you, oh God, for every person, even in the pews, oh God, that you would bless and touch each one of them, oh God, that you would allow them, oh God, to seek after you new things, oh God, that you will stir up a hunger, oh God, in each of the hearts of your people, oh God, even as they hear my voice, oh God, that you, as Angie was praying earlier, God, that those, oh God, will enter a deeper place in you, oh God, that you will rise up, oh God, a desire to pray and begin to just intercede on behalf of themselves and their families, oh God, and situations, oh God, that they're facing, oh God. We just thank you, oh God, for just continue to surround this place, oh God, and that you would take us to a new place, oh God, where there's no program, oh God, that you would be the one that would be the program giver, oh God, that you would just set a hold in this place, oh God. This altar will continue to be a fireplace, oh God, a place where you will manifest even more, oh God, more victory, more healing, more deliverance, oh God, more hearing of your voice, oh God, visions and dreams, oh God, that will continue and manifest throughout the day, throughout the weeks to come, oh God. We just thank you, God, for the children that are even here, oh God, that there will be something that was deposited into them, that will allow them, oh God, this week will be a fruitful week, oh God, a week of, oh God, just allowing them to see clearer and again hear your voice, oh God. We just thank and we bless you, oh God. We bless you, oh God, for Pastor David and Tracy, oh God, that you will continue to bless them, oh God. Continue to be with them, oh God, through this week, oh God, that you will bring forth, oh God, even more, oh God, that there will be more opportunities and more doors, less distractions, oh God, and allowing them to enter in a deeper place, oh God, to be able to bring to your people, oh God, but to each other, oh God, to be able to bless each other, be able to pray with each other, be able to get in the word together, oh God. We just thank and we bless you, Father. We thank you, oh God, for every person here, oh God, a layer of protection, oh God, of each person, oh God, that as they leave this place, oh God, that they would be protected, oh God, by you, oh Lord, and that we just thank you, oh God, for this region, oh God, and what you're doing and starting, oh God, afresh, oh God. I just hear the word reset. We just thank you, God, for hitting the reset button, oh God, in this place, oh God, allowing us to enter in into that reset place, oh God, being able to hear your voice, oh God, and to be able to operate and move, oh God, as you move, oh God. So we thank and we bless you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. Holy. Thank you, Jesus. Shoo. Yeah. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Can we just put our hands together for the Lord, please? Come on, give the Lord some thanks. Hallelujah. That was beautiful, Paula. See, I'm glad my singing can inspire people. If he can do it, anybody can sing. Come on. Paula, that was beautiful. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All right. Praise God. Praise God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's beautiful seeing people get touched by God. That's beautiful. It's really beautiful seeing people's first time here getting touched by God. Amen. Isn't that exciting? Getting healed in the heart. Come on. How many people got an upgrade from the Lord? I seen a lot of people, heart transformation. Amen. We just thank you, Lord. How you feeling, Jimmy? Good. All right. I love that. But Jimmy Maddox is a good friend. How many people know Jimmy Maddox and his wife, Margaret? Well, we're so glad to have him up here. You know, he moved a little closer. He was in Fredericksburg. Now he's still kind of far away to some people. But you live in Manassas, right? Yeah, so he lives in Manassas. Oh, it's in Molasses. But he's going to come and he's going to take this time to just let us know about the power of your seed, the power of giving. So can we put our hands together, one of our dear friends? Jimmy, love you, man.
Who's feeling really good after that, right? Amen. Whew. This morning when I woke up, I started meditating on the Lord. He brought me back to the cross. I always love it when the Lord brings you back to the cross. You know, because we get in all of these different studies that surround the cross, but when he brings you right back to the center of why you're here, then he's trying to tell you something, right? Everything that we do flows from that one spot. Everything that we do flows out of our experience at the cross. Amen? So I just want you to think about that for a moment. And I have a scripture here. So as you think about the cross, also think about Matthew 6:24, where the Bible says, "No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate one and love the other, or else he will be loyal to one and despise the other." You cannot serve God and mammon, or some translations say money. So you cannot serve God and money. And so we think about that, and often we say, "Oh, then money's bad. I need to push money to the side." But that's not what it's saying at all. Money's actually what we need in life for a lot of different things. So money itself is not bad. But when you put money before God, that's when it moves over into the bad category. Amen? So when I look at this and I think of the cross and all the things that Jesus was talking to me this morning, I started thinking about that 10% that we're supposed to give, right? Supposed to give our tithe, bring the tithe and the 10%. And this spirit of mammon that's talking about here is when you move into a place where you feel like you can help yourself, and so you keep that 10% and you spend it on a bill, right? Because the bill was due, so you took that 10% from God and you gave it into that electric bill instead of giving it to God. So what just happened? Actually, you gave into the spirit of mammon. And now the rest of that paycheck is cursed because you did not give God his 10%. Does that make sense? So one of the hugest things for Christians, if we want all of our finances to be blessed, is first to give that 10% to God. We take that, give it to God. He removes that spirit of mammon from the rest of our money, the rest of our paycheck that came in that week. And now our entire bucket of money is blessed. Number one rule, very simple, give your 10%. But what does he say about giving anything after 10%? What does he say about that? Because we bring in our 10% to protect the rest of our money. That's not really why we bring it in, but let's just put it in those terms. We bring in our 10% to protect the rest of our bucket so it's blessed, so it'll do everything that it is supposed to do. But then he says, now bring the offering into the house. When he says, bring the offering into the house, now that's where we say he's going to give back to you, shaken together, running over, right? So the 10% protects you, just using those words here. And then the offering, everything additional that you give, any money that you give, all the time you give to the church, all the time you spent painting the wall, all the time we spent preparing the food, all of that extra offering that you give to the Lord is now going to be given back to you tenfold, twentyfold, hundredfold, running over. So the Lord here is speaking to us about the spirit of mammon is not putting our trust in ourselves, being able to work that job and take that money and pay that light bill with that 10% that was supposed to go to God, but to give God that 10% and trust in him instead of our money. So money's not bad. Money's good. But we got to give him that 10%. How many people here have ever gotten blessed from the Lord financially? Yeah, let's stand up. Everybody's gotten blessed from the Lord financially. Sometime in your life, he's come through and he's given you what you needed in that right moment so you could move forward in whatever it was, right? All right. Now, how many people here need the Lord to move financially in you right now? Everybody else stand up, because everybody else needs the Lord to move for you financially. So today, everybody that's standing up, this is the reason why we give to the Lord, because we know he's going to come through for us, right? So we give in our 10%, we give our offering over, and then he brings it all back and throws it at us, running over from heaven. So everybody that's standing, you have done something, and you've worked the principles of God where you've given, and then you've reaped from that. So you know it's real. So today I'm asking you to go on what you already know. Go on the blessings that you received from the Lord and take back that control that you wanted yourself and give it back to the Lord. Amen? Can we do that this morning? Can we say, Lord, you have control over my money. You have control over every aspect of my life. And today, I remove myself from the equation, and I say, God equals God, and that's it. He is the all in all, right? All in all, he is all that I need. I don't have to rely on anything else. I don't have to let the spirit of mammon come into my life. You are my all in all. Man, those lights got brighter. They're like right now. Amen. So go ahead and prepare your offering, your 10%, your tithe, and the additional that you want to give tonight. I don't care if you're giving pennies. I don't care if you're giving dollars. I don't care if you're giving millions. Give something tonight so God has something to work in that principle so he can pour back out to you. If you bring nothing to him tonight, then he has nothing to work with. And so you remain in the place that you were. But if you bring something that he has to work with, then he has something to put that principle from heaven into place. So go ahead and prepare your offering. I'll just pray before we come. Father, we thank you tonight for everything that you've done for us. We thank you for the principle that you put in place where we give our first fruits into you and you give your blessing on the rest of our finances. Lord, we know that the rest of our finances are yours as well, but they're blessed now that we've given out of them. Father, we thank you for everything that we give over in abundance. You, Father, return back in the principle of heaven, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. So, Father, we just come against that spirit of mammon tonight that tries to take control over our finances. And so we say no, that God equals God equals God, and he is our all in all. He is all we need in our equation. In Jesus' name, amen. Go ahead and come.
I feel it in my bones, you're about to move. I feel it in the wind, you're about to ride in. You said that you would pour your spirit out. You said that you would fall on sons and daughters. So I feel it in my bones, you're about to move.
How many people believe the prayer of the righteous availeth much? Did I forget a word? What word did I forget in that scripture? That's all you know? All right, that's good. There's a missing one. Huh? There we go. Effectual. Effectual. There we go. Effectual fervent prayer of the righteous avail much. So, Lord, we just thank you, Lord, for gifts in your house, God. And we thank you, Lord, for partnering with heaven. We thank you, Lord, that our prayers are fervent. They're effectual. Lord, they're going to avail much. So we thank you, Lord, that our prayers avail much. And we just decree and declare you've broken off the spirit of mammon, the love of this world over your people. And we thank you, Lord, because of that, Lord, we are able to receive in abundance. And, Lord, we do this all because we love you and we want to be great stewards. And you have given us the power to get wealth, to create wealth, to be a blessing to so many. And we thank you for the honor and the privilege, Lord, to be your children. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Tell somebody next to you, say, thank you, partner. You guys are partnering with heaven, and that is a great joy. So, I don't see my cohort. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to do some quick announcements. You ready? Monday night, we have house church at Roy and Darlene's. House of Levi is going to be there. And also on Tuesday, training for reigning. Now, what they haven't told you yet, and this is a secret, so you need to get it out to your crew. Okay, you ready for a secret? Morning service didn't get the secret. You guys get the secret. This is the secret. We'll be announcing a winner in a few weeks for the outing because ultimately we got really, really blessed with this outing. And what we want to do is get a date, set it on people's calendars, and then we're going to tell everybody this is the last day. So we're not going to be able to go for months like we wanted to for scoring, but you know what I'll tell you? If you want to win, you know how to win. This is the last mile. So I want to say that to you guys so you know that as we're doing training for reigning, there's a lot of games involved because my son's involved. And he is he's the life of the party. So Freddie's always fun to have around. And so he wants to make sure that this Thursday, you know, I don't remember what he called it, but it was like this Tuesday. Sorry, thank you. This Tuesday is like going to be like a fear factor. So you got to figure out who's really brave on your team or who's never been and make them brave on your team. That's even better. So it's going to be a little crazy. So I just, as the pastor of this church, I want you guys to know I know nothing and no one will be harmed in the filming of this video. All right, so... So that's Tuesday, training for reigning. We also have House of Prayer going on during the weekdays. If you want to come out either Monday or Thursday for the days from 10 to 2, and then Wednesday's a special time for men to get together and pray. How many men enjoyed the time with the men's prayer, men's breakfast? Breakfast of Champions, that was good. I was in Georgia, so I was like bummed out. It was my idea. I was like, yeah, and then I'm like, oh, man. Well, anyway, this is the testimony. My dad is doing incredible. Thank you for your prayers. The effectual, fervent prayers of the righteous avail much. And it's really awesome. Basically, we got there 30 minutes. We drove. We worked. I worked Thursday. My sister and her husband worked Thursday. We left here at like 7:30 at night. We got there at like 5:50, he was supposed to go in pre-op at 6. We prayed with him right before he went into prep for surgery. And then as I was thinking of this baby, and it just distracted me. The baby's like looking up. I'm like, is the baby seeing angels or what's going on? So I got lost, sorry. So he got prepped for operation surgery. And then as we prayed for him, he just had a lot of peace. That day, they went to do a quadruple bypass, and they ended up going in and only needing to do a double bypass. And instead of taking 7 or 8 hours, they were done in 2.5 hours. And so we went and saw him, and he was kind of like barely able to talk. He looked like he was in so much pain, he didn't even want to be awake. And so I was like, we went home kind of early that day, went to bed, got up the next day. And when we get to the hospital at 9 o'clock, he's sitting up in his chair drinking whatever kind of nourishment they're giving him. And they're like, well, he needs to be walking around tomorrow. He needs to get on his feet, and he needs to be walking around. And I'm just like, what? Like, so he had his chest cut down the sternum and all the open heart surgery stuff. But nowadays, they're like, keep it moving, come on. Because they know when you just sit around and you just soak on it, you just get messed up. So somebody needs to tell somebody next to you, don't sit around, keep it moving. That's the key to health. Actually, my sister told me I should preach a message called, I should preach a message called Healing Hurts. She was like, see, like, if you don't push in, if you don't keep pressing when it hurts, then you'll end up giving into the pain. If you don't learn to press in when the pain's there, you end up giving into the pain, and then you don't actually move forward. So what other announcements did you have, Trace? Oh, that's, I already gave it to him. Yep. So the other thing is anybody that's going to Firestorm, praise God for you being able to take that time off for work. It starts Wednesday night.
Wednesday night starts with Todd White. We will be having a vehicle on Wednesday night and Friday night and Saturday going up and coming back. So if anybody would like to be in that part of the trip, you can shoot me a text message. Shoot me a text message, Tim, because when I get home on Monday mornings, generally I'm hungover and I have to wake up and get all my processes going in my head and try to remember everyone that I told everyone I was going to do something.
So if I wasn't saved, what would hangover meant?
Huh?
What does hangover meant if I was new to church?
Oh, spiritually hungover, just in his presence all day and in awe when you wake up and then realizing, like, I got to shake this off because now I got to go function, and you don't want to function. You just want to stay in bed and stay hungover. Does that make sense? I don't know.
I think half the people got it at
That's
least.
That's what I go through on a Monday morning before I get out of bed, everybody. It's a battle. Sometimes I think I don't want to get out of bed.
Struggle's real, Tracy.
So, not to stay in bed, but just to stay with him.
Amen.
Yeah. Don't get jealous.
You're allowed to take him out of bed.
Yeah, I know. He comes with me. Don't worry. So Wednesday night, Friday night, and Saturday morning, a vehicle will go up and come back. That's in Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Everybody else that's going for the whole trip, if you did not re-text me your name, like I asked last week, I have communicated with some people this week, I got that. But last week I asked that you re-text me. If you did not, I'm going to assume that you're not going. I'm not going to assume it on one text because I've had people's schedules already change. People thought they could go, then they told me they had to work, they couldn't go. They thought they had the finances, then they didn't have the finances. So I'm not going to assume. I'm not going to take this trip, reserve rooms, and budget things on one person telling me one time they can go. I need you to tell me again that you're definitely going. Okay, so that's that. Today after service, some people are asking me, Anna is having a birthday party at the Olive Garden. And we want to say happy birthday to Paula as well. Happy birthday. So she got to go enjoy her day yesterday. But everyone that would like to go to the Olive Garden, it is open to anyone. However, people have been asking me, is the church paying for it? The church is not paying for this birthday party. That is individually on you if you go. And it is nice to celebrate. You can go and just get some water. The salads are always free at the Olive Garden. Well, there'll be other people eating meals that can share a salad. We could sneak a little salad here and there. Oh, I didn't say that. No. Sorry. But all kidding aside, I can't agree to something like that because, you know, then I don't know how many people would show up and, you know, I don't know. So, but plus because the trip's coming up, I have to budget. I have to be wise because I have a lady in my office. If y'all haven't met Marcy yet, Marcy, where you at? Marcy will kick my booty. Do you hear me back there? Anyway, Morningstar is coming up too. And also Kim Abbott will be here the weekend of Morningstar. We come back that Sunday. Kim Abbott will also be with us on that Sunday. That Friday night, I've been told that Kim Abbott's going to be doing worship at the Cave. And then I also was told that, I'm going to probably say this name wrong, and it's just really an honor, and that's why I'm going to say it. Is the football player's name Ray Lewis? Yes, he's going to be at the Cave Friday night as well. The Friday that, it's not March Friday when Kim's there? No, sorry, I had it wrong. I thought it was the same Friday. Okay. Okay, no worries. Freddie will announce that. I got it wrong. The other announcement that I've been asked to announce is that we are no longer going to be supplying in March bottled waters for everybody for free. Some people heard this already this morning. It's not easy for me to stand up here and announce this because I love blessing people. But the reason that a group of people have gotten together and they're rebuking me, and I'm okay with that because people have been wasting the water. We're literally on the end of two services. We collect, Daisy, how many bottles did you collect that day? No, it was more than a dozen. You said you had like 40. Oh, dozens. Sorry. Thank you. That sounds more like it. One person counted 60 bottles of water with a quarter of the water drank out of it. Now, what I really couldn't understand, I appreciate you leaving it here so that way I know what's going on. But there are trash cans in the building. See, I would have never known. But God does things for a reason because he knows one of my biggest prayers is for this house to be a good steward in everything we do. We don't just give 80%. That 80-20 rule does not operate in this house. We are 100% in and 100% in everything for the kingdom. All of us, 100% of you into 100% of everything. That's the other part of the vision for this house. I want to break all that 80-20 stuff off churches because I don't agree with it, okay? But long story short, I'm being outvoted on keeping the water bottles. They will be sold for $1 a piece. It breaks my heart, and I'm going to say it again, that we can't value what's given, that we have to value what's paid for sometimes more. To me, I mean, I can't get that, but that's all right. God's teaching me still. I'm learning. I love you all. And Pastor David, oh, we can release the children. We do have a testimony if Jonathan's in here right now. Jonathan? Okay. Do we want to get Jonathan? Nope. Okay. Doug just went to get him.
It's okay.
Okay.
All right. Well, praise God. Let's get this party started. You want to pray for me?
Yeah, sure.
All right. Come on. Bring some of that glory. Bring some of that fire. Thank you, Lord. Ooh. Fervent. The effectual fervent prayer.
I think he's
going to
pray for me, everybody. I think he's
avail
much.
No.
All right. If everyone just stretches your hands toward Pastor David, Lord. Lord, we just thank you for what you've already done, Papa. Yeah. But it's not over yet, Father God. And I just thank you for every word, Father God. Every word that's alive, Lord, that's going to come through Pastor David, Lord.
Yes.
We just pray that it just settles in our hearts, Father God, and it breaks what needs broken, Father God. It changes what needs changed, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And that we learn to just humble ourselves, Father God, even if we are.